morning from Tsendze rustic campsite. Had a lovely sleep last night. There was quite a bit of activity around the tent last night. Not sure if this might check some tracks. Pretty sure it was just a honey badger, but we'll see. Rikus didn't hear anything. Did you hear anything, Ricky?
No, this guy slept like a rock. I heard nothing.
At least he slept well. We'll be heading off for our morning drive soon. We're just going to do a couple of loops around Tsendze today. Take it easy. Maybe go walk around Mubani. And yeah, let's see what we can find.
After a while, we came across some tsetse in the distance. The little ones were running and playing. Even the zebra joined in. This was quite a special sight because you do not see them often, especially in the park. So we just turned off the car and sat there, watching them play. Until a big ellie strolled in and spoiled the fun. Still a great sighting though.
Right everyone, so we just stopped here at the Tropic of Capricorn lookout. We can just have a stop here quickly. We stopped here to have a bit of a stretch of the legs. So I don't know really what's going on here, because I thought it's going to be one huge dotted line, but apparently it's just a bunch of rocks. We've just done the Tropic of Capricorn loop as well. Quite a nice drive. Seen some nice birds, some elephants drinking at the waterholes. So we're going to head back down now to Mupani side, down to Moipla's picnic spot to have some breakfast. It's going to be nice.
We are here at Moipla's picnic site. It's absolutely beautiful. Lots of water. We've been here before when we stayed at Letaba and it did not have this much water. Rikus is on the hunt for a spookful or a grey-headed bushrike. You might hear it calling in the background. Where there's a lot of hippo around and a lot of birdies. So we'll have a coffee and a rusk and then we're up again. Did you get him, Riggy?
Got him.
If you are ever in the Mupani area, I would suggest coming to my place. It is really stunning, and that river view while drinking coffee was superb. I would really suggest it. And while you're here, have a look out for the grey-headed bushrike, or aka the squirquel. We're going to probably go for a little drive to one of the hides here close by and see what birdies we can find there as well. We are here at Pioneer Bird Hide, just outside Pioneer Bird Hide. You can look out on Mupani Rest Camp over there. Really stunning here, hey?
It's beautiful. And we're gonna have a field day now.
We are here at the Shipondeni Hide, just above the Tsendze low water bridge. The Pioneer Hide was very fruitful, but let's just see what we can find here. Alright, beautiful as well.
We are busy doing Mupani's little walk around camp. And how stunning is it? The beautiful Pioneer Dam view on most of your walk. Pretty cool. The photographers are just a little bit behind me. They are busy capturing a giant kingfisher. It's one of the things Ricky said he loves seeing in the bush. Usually you see him on the low water bridges sitting on the edges. But yeah, we saw them. Yeah, we saw him in a tree. Cool.
I don't know where to look, left or right, inside the bush or on the water, I'm not sure. But it's beautiful. It's lovely.
Too many options. Joking. It's cool. Photographers in the wild. We are back at Tsendze rusty campsite after a wonderful little morning drive. Well, it turned out to be quite a long one, but we spent a lot of time at the bird hides and at the Tsendze low water bridge, which is stunning, and a little walk around Mupani. And now we are going to just have a chilled afternoon at Tsendze, maybe do some birding, have a little nap, and go for a drive later probably. Yep. Okay, so it's almost time for our evening drive this evening. I went for a lovely little outdoor shower. Oh, so refreshing. One of my friends that have camped at Tsendze before told me or recommended that I go for a shower in the afternoon and not at night when it is dark. Remember, Tsendze doesn't have electricity, so it can get quite dark in the bathrooms at night. So remember to bring your own lights to the bathroom. But it was really nice. I highly recommend an afternoon shower when it is still light. There's lots of birdies above you in the trees, which is quite cool. I feel refreshed before my afternoon drive. So had a little nap this afternoon in the hammock. That was superb. And Ricky saw lots of birdies, one of them being a woodpecker, golden-tailed woodpecker, and a red-headed weaver, which is pretty cool. So yeah, but let's head out for our afternoon drive. We are here at Tsendze low water bridge and we have some very happy birders in the car. Ricky, what are you photographing over there?
You actually just spotted a greater painted snipe sneaking around in the
It's a beautiful, beautiful little birdie. Stunning. Very cool. We just got back from our evening drive, had a successful little drive in terms of birding.
Absolutely.
Very good. I think people are going to start getting bored of our birding videos, but we're going to take a little walk around Tsendze camp and see what we can find around camp. I see it's a ritual. I see everybody takes a little stroll around camp in the evenings. It's quite cool. Wow, what a beautiful day it has turned out to be. I must say, looking at this scene, it does not look like I'm in a camp right now. I can see why it's Tsendze rustic campsite. It really feels like I'm in the bush at the moment. Rikus and I just saw a genet go up this tree, or actually down the tree into the long grass behind us right now. So we are trying to see if we can find him. What's on the fire, Mr. Briar?
We have some vegetable kebabs for all the healthy ones around us. And then we also have some nice fillet in the bright tonight. And there's also some scarp chops left that we still have to do. And I might add another bag of wood just because.
Okay guys, so that's a wrap on today's shenanigans. Yeah, our second last night at Tsendze, and second night at Tsendze. had a good day of birding.
Yeah.
Had a lovely outdoor shower.
A cold outdoor shower.
For you. But yeah, otherwise it was a good day and we're looking forward to tomorrow. Tomorrow we're going to Grootvlei Dam
along the S50. And then all the way up to Shingwetsi, and then coming back down to Tsendze. That's going to be our big trip for tomorrow.
But if you're ever in this area, Mupani, Tsendze, go to the Tsendze Low Water Bridge.
Really, absolutely really stunning. We had elephants visiting us this evening.
Not on the dam though, but far away.
We were late. They were on time. We were late. But we had elephants there, and then I think the highlight of the day probably then the greater painted snipe, which is a very, very exciting. But yeah, all in all, brilliant day.
Yeah. Okay, we'll see you guys in the next vlog.
Cheers.
Thank you for tuning in to our stay here at Tsendze Rustic Camp. If you have never been, I would highly recommend it. If you have been here, I know you are either missing it to bits or already planning your next stay here. If we have misidentified any birds, please leave us a comment to correct us. No hard feelings. We are almost done with week one of our 20-day trip. It only gets better from here. So like, subscribe, and do not miss a thing. Stay tuned. Cheers.
Rikki, what did you see? We just spotted an African painted sandpiper.
Greater painted snipe.
Oh my word. We just saw a greater. I can't remember.
Greater painted snipe.
Greater, but I don't know.